Alisa Edwards. Did you call my number?
You were the contestant number one, the one and only.
Oh, let's do it.
Did I fuck that up?
Hold on, you fucked it up. You're up for elimination.
Thank you so much.
So what I want you to say is, I want you to say,
hold on.
Hold the fuck on, helpers! I want you to say, in question and answer, Miss Texas, contestant number one.
Friends, colleagues, family, and distinguished guests of Perth. Welcome to the Drag Fest 2017 pageant. I'm already going to forget what she was going to say. It's Miss World. Miss World. This is Miss World. And we have approached the question and answer segment of the evening. And I would like you to welcome to the stage contestant number one from Mesquite, Texas. Oh, that's it. Contestant number one from Mesquite, Texas, Miss Alisa Edwards!
Thank you, judges! You gotta do this for real, okay? Because I'm gonna show you how fucking good I was on this. Now, I'm not gonna count those crowns, but I want every one of those motherfuckers out right. Okay. You ready?
Okay, I'm good.
You got the question?
Contestant.
Pull a Steve Harvey, bitch. Make this good.
Contestant number one. She's dignified, she's gracious, and she's drop dead gorgeous.
And you sure wanna keep going?
She has a secret. Contestant number one, what is your secret?
Thank you, Karen. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, friends, fans, family, and foes. Hailing from the Lone Star State, I am contestant number one, the only contestant in the competition. My name is Alisa Edwards. I would like to thank all of my sponsors, my family, and I would like to thank God above for giving me the opportunity to be the person I am today. And in response to the question, I believe sharing is caring, however, there are some secrets you just keep to yourself. Because if I did share the ultimate secret, I probably wouldn't have been given the opportunity to share my art with the world that I have tonight. But if I am going to share secrets, I can share one secret, just one, with you, Miss Karen, and you judges. The secret is officially out. I just wrapped filming my reality series based around my dance school. The secret you wanted to hear, bitch. But that's the only secret I'm going to be sharing on this gig on tonight. But I'm so very excited it's going to be shown internationally. So you guys, I started doing drag. Okay, here we go. The long-winded portion. Well, first of all, how many of y'all watch Alisa's Secret? Because one story goes to the next, to the next, to the next, and then 6 hours later, I'm like, I'm getting tired of going home. And I take the wheel. Well, 1 year I remember I was competing for Miss Texas, I think I was 23, I was probably one of the front runners to win. And I get on stage interview, and you know, my pageant coach would tell me, Justin, here's the deal. I want you to answer the question, shut the fuck up. Don't you go on stage talking about, you know, your whole lifelong experience and every dance class, every dance teacher you studied under. And I got up there one time and I was like, my favorite food is Mexican in the color is purple. I like long walks on the beaches. I love to swim. I remember I went to swimming lessons when I was 7 or 8 and I almost drowned. My mom jumped in the water. And if we went to the lake and the family, oh, the audience was like this. And I lost the pageant. I was a beautiful first alternate that night. And they told me, they said, well, you talked too much in the interview. I said, I was trying to share with y'all. It was very sincere. It was serious. I was getting, and then I ended with this. And my favorite dogs are Dalmatian. I don't even own a fucking dog. So, but I was going along with it. But, what was the question? That was it right there.
That was the secret.
That's how I thought it up, right there. You know, that's exactly, I forgot where I was going. I got on one subject, I got on the mess, and then I just got turned around. But no, I got started in drag. It was something that I experienced for fun. I found it to be very intriguing, compelling. It was campy and funny. I never said that. I was a very shy, if you believe this, introverted little gay boy. And I was in the back of the gay bar, and I was like, fucking Bozo the Clown is up on stage. And I just, it was very like Karen from Finance. And I found it to be so fun. And I told my friends, I'm going to do it. And they said, well, how are you going to do it? I don't know. So I had four sisters. So I took my boy hair and I swooped it over and put some butterfly clips. This is a true story too. Oh my gosh. I know we don't got long, do we? Here we go. I swooped my boy hair over, okay? Put some butterfly clips in my hair. I put on one of my sister's dance leotards. And I went to the open mic. All right, for the yay over there in the audience. I went to the open night talent show, and I'll be a motherfucker if I didn't win. And a part of winning, you had to come back. And the host drag queen, she told me, you're very talented. And she said, well, what do you want your name to be? Because I didn't have a name. I just said, I'm just going to be a participant number one, entry number one. And I said, my name's going to be Alyssa. She said, Alyssa? I said, yeah, like Alyssa Milano. I've always wanted to be her. She said, well, that's not very creative. And I was offended. I said, creative? Alyssa Milano was beautiful. She said, it don't fucking matter, Alyssa is. Get yourself ready and come back next week. And you need to buy yourself a wig. And I said, well, where am I going to get that? And so I met one of my friends, friend of a friend of a friend. He was friends with the drag queen. So he told me, if you go back next week, I'll let you wear a wig. I said, oh my gosh, I need a wig. I went back the next week, and here I am 17 years later. I don't know what the fuck or how, but my true passion is being in the studio, creating magic through the art of movement, and I'm just so very grateful and thankful for this experience. And how many of you, I gotta say this too, how many of y'all love All Stars 2? I done sashayed away three fucking times, okay? Three times, baby. I was still in it to win it. But when I left there, I said, oh my gosh, I can't believe this girl. I couldn't even get in the top fucking four. But at least I moved up. I was sixth place on season 5. I got to fifth place on All Stars. And the next thing I know, I get a call, and they're like, Alyssa, we're so excited. The show's going to be a double.
Just a birthday description!
this journey. We'll see you again, very, very soon.